Toronto. That's not a painting. That's real life.
That's where you live.
Wow.
There it is.
Outstanding. Good morning on a Monday. Meredith Shaw, Sid Sixero here with you. Who's the lead singer of the Bengals again?
Oh, gosh.
Who was?
Carlisle.
Not Belinda Carlisle. It is not.
No?
The Go-Go's. The Bengals. Hold on.
I don't know.
The Bengals. That's Manic Monday. That's the Bengals. Don't gaslight me into not knowing the Bengals.
Yes. It is the Bengals.
Susanna Hoff.
Good job, you guys.
I'm trying to know who that is. I don't know. But normally, see, here's what happens.
Yeah.
Here's why I tried that.
Right.
Normally, when you yell out something on this show, whether you want an answer or not,
you get it.
Johnny, I know the answer's in my ear like this.
Right.
And has the correct response.
But it's a Monday, Sid.
I thought that was going to be flowing back our way.
It was not, unfortunately.
Anyway, I'm a fan of
the Now we all know.
Suzanne? Yes.
Hoff.
Pop, a legendary track. Good morning, as we move past that blazing start to the show. True story, Meredith asked me Friday, what are you doing this weekend? And I go, well, I have there's a Yorkdale thing.
Hey, you got new clothes?
Adriana and Amanda and Karen, shout out to all of them at Yorkdale Friday. I had that after work. You'll be seeing that over the next few weeks. Quick preview, I look good. And after that,
yes,
I had nothing, absolutely nothing. Had a non-alcoholic Peroni on the schedule. That was about it. A lot of football, a lot of fantasy sports. And I go, Meredith, what are you doing this weekend? And Meredith says to me with a straight face, not much. Can you walk people through what you did this weekend?
Well, your definition of not much
is putting me to shame.
No, Sid. No. But the difference is, you know, they're children. And when children live with you, things need to happen, right? You can't just do nothing. They need to be occupied. And we occupied them in the very best way. We went to Legends of Horror at Casa Loma. Oh, my gosh.
I hear it's quite the setup this year.
See, this is the very family-friendly moment at the end. If you want to take a nice pic, you can. Of course, you know, we did the thing where someone saw us struggling, trying to take a group photo, and then a lovely dad was like, hey, do you want me to take it? And I said, sure. And then I said, do you want me to return the favor? You know, that like quid pro quo that happens when you take a photo. Anyway, thank you to that man. It was very scary. And we went family hours, which, by the way, exist. So you can go early, so the sunlight's still up, and there are no live actors, you know.
Also, if you go, so that's what I need to do.
Yeah.
I go to Legends of Horror.
Right, you just go to family
hours.
I have
to go to the 1 p.m. show.
Yeah, you go a little early. But no, it really was phenomenal. The detail was amazing. But it's scary. It was scary. Yeah, so we had a good time. And then we went to the Taylor Swift movie.
Okay, do tell. Did you get up and dance? Were you a Swiftie at the front of the theater and people in the back were like, sit down? And you were like, no.
You know, Sid, we talked about this on the show. And I did not have a full grasp. It is one of the sweetest experiences you can have. Thank goodness people are getting up and dancing. It's just, it makes you feel like everything's gonna be okay. Seriously, I'm not kidding. And I really was thinking about the appeal of Taylor Swift and then her just sort of massive hold she has on everybody. And I think that's what she is. I think she's hope and optimism and goodness. And as a parent, you let your children run to the front of the theater and you're not worried what's going to happen to them at the front of the theater. You're like, go for it.
The kids ran to the front to be in the Taylor mosh pit, so to speak.
And it's one of the sweetest mosh pits you've ever seen. It's so heartwarming. And, you know, it's emotional, the movie. She is so good. That movie is so good.
How is it emotional? Isn't it not just, again, I haven't seen it. I'm from the land of ignorance on this. It seems like a concert film to me, which I have seen before. How is this any different?
It's what she's representing right now. And I think it's such a beautiful thing. And it's more than music, and that's why everybody's into it. It just means things are going to be okay. She really is unbelievable. And I was so moved by the movie in a way that I didn't think. It is long, though, okay?
How long is it?
It is over 3 hours. Yeah, it's her show.
Is this a Scorsese film?
It's her show.
3 hours?
It's three hours long, yeah.
Okay.
So be prepared for that.
Okay.
But do it. Oh, it's good, Sid. It's really, really good. And from a production point of view, everybody here, you don't catch one camera in a shot. I don't know how they did that. Because they've got so many sweeping all the shots everywhere, you don't see one camera anywhere. Anyway, very impressive on multiple ways.
Maybe I'll go. I'll try not to dance.
You just have to go with someone.
I have to go see, yeah.
Yeah.
46-year-old in the theater is not a good look.
Yeah, no.
No.
Sit alone.
Someone younger. Yes.
We'll find you a date.
Thanks.
An appropriate...
At Breakfast TV. Who wants to come with me to see the Taylor Swift movie?
Taylor Swift.
It's 7:01. Happy Monday. You're watching BT.